Good morning. Today our lesson, water distribution on earth. Water is very important for our life. So during the lesson, we'll discuss the following points. One, identify how water is distributed on earth. Second, describe what powers the water cycle and how water moves through this cycle. Water is simply two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen bonded together. Without water, life might not be able to exist on earth. Water is widely distributed on earth as fresh water and salt water in the oceans. If you look at the map of the world, you will get an idea about the ocean cover on the earth. Earth is the blue planet because when viewed from space, it appears blue. This blue color is caused by reflection from the ocean, which cover roughly 70% of the area of the earth. As I told, earth is the blue planet because earth is special because it has so much water. It's in the ground and forms big ocean. And it's in our atmosphere and all living things. Your body is mostly made up of water. Next one, hydrosphere. A hydrosphere is the total amount of water on the surface of the earth. Hydro means water. Sphere means ball. The hydrosphere includes water. That is on the surface of the planet, underground and in the air. A planet's hydrosphere can be liquid, vapor, or ice. On Earth, liquid water exists on the surface in the form of oceans, lakes, and rivers. Here you can see oceans, ice, forms. Three states of matter. Water is the only substance on earth that is present in all three states of matter as a solid, liquid, or gas. And earth is the only planet where water is present in all three states. Let's see three phases of water. Solid, for example, ice or snow. Liquid, water. Gas, for example, water vapor. Here you can see some of the figures. Solid example, glacier and ice. It's in the form of frozen form. And the next one, it's liquid, water. And the third one, it's water vapor in the atmosphere. Let's discuss water distribution on Earth in detail. Water covers 70% of the Earth surface. Next, we can see in what percentage it's water distributed in oceans, lakes, rivers, underground water, and ice. As I told previously, water covers 70% of the entire surface of the Earth, and most of it is ocean water. Water has been associated with the existence of life. Earth's water. In fact, 97% of the total water on the Earth is in the form of oceans and seas. So most of the water is salty and no use for drinking, farming, or industries. Here you can see Earth water, 3% fresh water, 97% of salt water found in ocean. Next, we can see the fresh water. Only 3% of fresh water. So we have only this water that we can really use in our daily life. But even all of that cannot be used. Fresh water is used by us for drinking, farming, and industries, but we cannot really get to use the fresh water in the ice cap and atmosphere. So the amount of fresh water that we can actually use is very less. Only very less amount of fresh water we can use. That's why fresh water should be used very carefully. Even every drop of water is precious. Let us see the types of fresh waters. Glacier. Here you can see the image of glacier. What is glacier? A thick sheet of ice. Or we can say a huge mass of ice that permanently covers an area of land. Next, ice caps. It is a type of glacier. is a thick sheet of ice often found in the North and South Poles or in mountain regions. See, glacier means the word comes from the old French word glaze meaning ice. Same way, ice cap are sometimes called polar caps and can be classified as a type of glacier. Let us see in detail about the percentages. Only about 3% Earth's water is fresh water. But how much is available for human use? 69% is ice, glacier, and snow cover. It's in the form of solid or frozen. 30% it's groundwater. Groundwater is water stored in the cracks and spaces between particles of soil and underground rocks. Next one, less than 1% is running water in rivers and standing water in lakes. The next one, 0.037% is water vapor. It's a tiny bit of Earth's water. It's found in the atmosphere as water vapor. In this image, you can see very clearly the vast one. The large amount of water is salt water, 97%. And then remaining 3% fresh water, in that 2% it's frozen form of water or solid form of water. And the 1% is running water and standing water and the atmosphere water vapor. And the very less 1% is available for human consumption. Next, 30% of fresh water is groundwater. Less than 1% of fresh water is found in rivers and lakes. In this image, you can see how much amount of water is there in there on the earth. Distribution of water. In the first image, all water on earth. That means the two main kinds of resources. Saline. Saline means salt water. And the next one, fresh water. From the fresh water, ice caps and glaciers. Solid form of water. Groundwater and other forms or liquid form of water. Then surface waters, lakes, then rivers and swamps. Here you can see some of the sources of water. The first image, you can see the ocean water, salt water, and the second one, solid form of water, frozen, glacier, ice cap. Here, the standing water, lakes, large area of water surrounded by land. It may be natural or artificial. Here, pond. This is another example for standing water. It is smaller than lake. This image represents river. River is very important form of running water. It's long, large and deep and fast flowing fresh water. This one, it's stream. Stream is smaller than river and mostly slow flowing water. Sometime the stream also fast flowing water is there. It's depend upon the heavy rain or flood on the surface of the soil. Next, let us discuss about the water cycle. Because water is important resource. Without water, we cannot live. So it must be continue. So in the water cycle, you can see many stages. Evaporation and condensation and precipitation. And this water cycle need energy. The energy from the sun causes water to evaporate. First, we can see what is water cycle. The water cycle also known as the hydrologic cycle or the hydrological cycle describes the continuous movement of water on, above, and below the surface of the earth. Energy from the sun causes water to evaporate. In the water cycle, the first step, evaporation. What is evaporation? Water changes from a liquid to a gas. That gas is called water vapor. The water vapor remains in the atmosphere until it undergoes condensation to become tiny droplets of liquid. Here you can see the evaporation and condensation. Evaporation means liquid changes into gas. Or water changes into water vapor. In the condensation process, all it can form clouds. This main process by sun. The next process or the next step, precipitation. Precipitation can be rain, sleet, hail, or snow. Sometimes precipitation falls back into the ocean. And sometimes it falls onto the land surface. Here you can see very clearly how the precipitation forms. Warm air and cold air, then dew point, from the dew point it brings the rain or sleet or hail or snow. Next one, runoff. Surface runoff is water from rain, snow, melt, or other sources that flows over the land surface and is a major component of the water cycle. All the land water run off and flow towards the ocean or some other rivers. Some water soaks into the ground through small spaces between particles of soil and cracks in rock. Some of this soil water is absorbed by plants. Next step, transpiration also happening. Transpiration is the process of water movement through a plant and its evaporation from aerial parts such as leaves, stems, and flowers. Transpiration is similar to evaporation. Both the process, the liquid water turn or change into gas. Transpiration takes place through plants, but evaporation from the water bodies, even on the earth surface, land. Groundwater. Groundwater is the water found underground in the cracks and spaces in soil, sand, and rock. Here you can see unsaturated zone, but here saturated zone. The groundwater table is there. And here, small amount of surface water. And the groundwater fills the spaces between soil particle and fractured rock beneath the earth surface. Water cycle in the water cycle, evaporation from oceans, lakes, and streams or all the water bodies, then condensation in the atmosphere, from that precipitation again the water can reach the earth in the form of rain, snow, sleet, hail. Then surface runoff and groundwater. Because it is a cycle. The water cycle has no beginning and no end. Water is renewable resource, that is, circulate through the water cycle. So, at the end of the lesson, you know about 70% of the earth is covered by water. The water found on earth makes up the hydrosphere. Hydrosphere means all the water included under hydrosphere, all forms of water. And also, you know there are two main kinds of water resources you can find on earth's surface, salt water and fresh water. And also, you can find water on earth's surface, many places, in the form of snow, rivers, streams, lakes, ponds, and oceans. Even though very less amount of fresh water is used for human activities.